Red Alert 2 World Series Pro Division action coming at you guys, and today we have something a little bit different. I put together what I call a flash tournament. Basically, I got 12 of the best players in the world, and instead of doing a big, drawn-out, long, multi-week series, I had them all go at it in one day, best of one, last man standing, taking home the cash prize. Now, today's video is a highlight from a semifinal game between Marco and Ed. Now, Marco, any of you guys unfamiliar, we call him the GOAT, the greatest to ever do it. He's been dominating at the top level for over a decade. Now, Ed, also a top-level player, he's unpredictable, he's unorthodox, he's always fun to watch, but he's never really beaten Marco in a big traditional series. But today, it's best of one, it's fast, it's quick, and Ed is coming for the GOAT. Buckle in, guys, this one gets wild. And as always, if you enjoy the video, liking, commenting, subscribing, all that stuff is free for you, helps me immensely. I'm trying to get more people watching, playing, and streaming this awesome game. It's really as simple as that. With that, let's go. Yeah, Marco, and that's why, again, guys, that's why Marco's the GOAT to me, man. Any game mode, any faction, any tournament style, any rules, any day of the week versus any opponent, he'll play, he'll crush him. You know, compared to some other top-level players, you know, who one game mode, one set of rules, they pick the factions, they pick the maps, they pick the vetoes, and they need the prize pool, you know? Marco's down, man, hanging and banging. So, any of you guys who missed it, it was a little bit of a gentleman's agreement here in the lobby. Ed said, Marco, you go allied, I'll go sub, and Marco agreed. Marco's the kind of guy who hops in the ring, man. He says, here, let me tie one arm behind my back, someone hold my beer. But Marco now knows the map, dialed in here as we get to sort of the end of this bracket. Again, guys, it's single elimination at this point. Marco versus Ed, winner goes on to play the winner of God, who knows? That brackets all over the place.
I want you to look at Marco's build. Never touch the map. Look at Marco's build right now. Does this look like a person who's played this map once in a different starting position as a different faction? Or does this look like someone who knows this map inside out? That is insane.
And the power plant right here. So he's going to get on this gem patch top left. And Root, you know Root's smiling right now. So Root, any of you guys unfamiliar, Root top level allied player. He just got into map making. This is one of his first maps. Beautiful map, by the way. Well played, Root. But this gem patch up here to stretch down to that gem patch is a sneaky one. Root's excited that Marco figured that out.
Well, yeah, but he's. I don't think you could stretch directly down. I think you have to go more to the top right corner, and only then, from there, you can build down. Because building straight down from a cliff is very, very hard. Marco has some Grizzlies on the field, and he is on Ed's side of the map here. Ed responding with rhinos of his own, trying to counter Marco's maneuvers right now.
Ooh, and Marco
going all the way down.
Ooh. Marco's tanks coming in a straight line. Marco's just... Oh man, Marco out with the Harrier now. One war factory, big economy, four refineries. But yeah, I thought he was going to be able to build down that cliff. Looks like he won't be able to. Couple drones now for Ed.
Yeah, nice drones to counter Marco's split. And that's something that's a very clever one. Was like, I don't have time or energy to micro an extra split versus the GOAT. I'm just going to make two drones and send them against that split. And it works. Forces Marco's tanks into one group. No more split. Marco keeps building down the left side here. And Ed is now actually threatening on the left side. They're passing each other. They're kind of ignoring each other's armies right now. Marco is the one who's going to retreat and go back to defend.
Yeah, of course, Allied versus Soviet, a base trade situation. A Soviet player loves to take it because of the drones. In a base trade situation versus Grizzlies, drones, great. A Soviet player can take a base trade in any position. Paradrop trying to cut off Ed's retreat. Ed sees it, though, doesn't get his fodder caught by it. Nice unit control there. Root saying, yeah, you messed up that power plant position, so not able to get down there, but definitely the right idea. Yeah, it's funny, someone in the chat saying, wait, Ivor always roots for Allied, but Ivor also always roots for the underdog. Yeah, who am I rooting for here? I always root for Allied. I always root for the underdog. I'm broken. That broke my AI. I don't know what to do now.
I'm rooting for a great game. And look at this split from Ed. Marco's immediate response there. Beautiful as the miner gets chronoed away. Now, Marco's economy is in a very awkward situation. All of his miners on a single patch, they're stepping on each other's toes right now. Not the type of economy the Allied player wants to have, or any player for that matter.
Fodder advantage, bunch of rhinos. Ed's going for it.
Ed's engaged.
Big fodder advantage. Okay, fodder gone now for Ed. Marco barebacking it. Marco needs to retreat.
No. Marco has the numbers. Marco actually wins that What?
Oh.
How did he win that fight?
And so
the GOAT.
This is one of those.
The GOAT.
And Ed hops up on the cliff. Now that's one of those positions.
No, he needs to get out of there. That's it.
Okay, nice. So Ed holds that. Now that's one of those positions where all of a sudden you see Marco comes out six tanks ahead and you're like, oh, he's way ahead. He's not way ahead because all of those Grizzlies were smoking. So you saw the reinforcements clean them up. Paradrop as well, getting way too much chip damage on those rhinos. Oh, Ed, buddy, Ed. Oof, Oof, now a
that
bunch
was
of
huge value.
Ed getting so much value, or Marco getting so much value out of his pair of drops here. Nice tactical positions. Now he's able to expand a little bit more now on a lot of ore as he gets over to Battle Lab Tech. And this is not where Ed wanted to win that engagement, and Ed wanted to get a couple miners or some kind of offensive value out of that into the late game here. This is where things can get really, really tricky for the when the Mirages start coming. And now Ed needs to be thinking about a Deso Bomb. But Ed showing a lot of patience today. We saw it in the last game as well here. Normally you expect Ed to kind of go be hitting the base trade, be hitting the sell, be hitting the wacky button. Ed's playing this one straight up, and I love to see it, but it's going to get a little scary here in the late game.
Did you see that positioning? The Rocketeer, yeah. The Pillbox, and then the Mirage moving into the cliff position to get some value on Ed's retreat. Marco with perfect Mirage control here. Looks like allied home player here. Yeah. Very, very nice.
And the paradrops in all these positions. So on a big map like this, guys, late game position, if you start, you know, you're attacking downfield, you're sending your reinforcements, these sneaky paradrops will pick off your tanks one by one. All of a sudden, you're like, where are the reinforcements? They're all dead. So these annoying paradrops on these cliffs like this, you start filling all these little nooks and crannies with paradrops, makes a very, very difficult position for a Soviet player late game on a map like this. Now, Ed's got to go Desolator, right? And here they come, multiple Deso Bombs, and This is it. It all comes down to this one big Deso Bomb. Ed will roll through a stuffed Deso Bomb. Marco will roll through. Let's go, boys. Grizzly splitting top side, Mirage's bottom side. Marco dances so nicely for these. Look at the one Mirage. He micros the one Mirage, but Ed comes back. Whoa. Top level rock,
nice
paper, scissors
micro
right there.
Nice micro. Now a Chrono Legionnaire out for Marco as well. This Grizzly split being cut off by Ed, so very nice defense from Ed there. And now the Desos are out. And he gets the Mirages on the retreat. Marco in trouble, boys. But the
Mirage is on the cliff.
The Mirage on the cliff getting huge value here. Marco has enough Mirages to defend this. He might lose his battle lab if Ed clicks it. No, he doesn't click it. He walks right through. The Mirage will keep chasing down the Rhinos, and they will take them out. Oh, but he gets an Elite.
So
Will the Elite survive? Marco takes out the Elite.
Okay, so you guys saw there. So some of Ed's reinforcements, like I talked about, came through this alley here and did take some damage. Did Ed get anything out of that? Did he get Deso Bomb?
Another Deso Bomb. Single Desolator.
But now
Marco's
he can zone
positioning
out.
Brilliant.
He can zone out,
but that was beautiful out of Marco. And the Deso keeps chasing. Marco has to tiptoe around this desolation circle here. More pillbox would be necessary. Another pillbox would be really nice to take out this desolator. Desolator getting value.
Miners?
Okay, it does go down.
Nothing on the backside at the moment. So Marco had some grizzlies on that backside, but I was watching. Maybe he pulled them back or Ed maybe took them out.
Ed countered them. Ed countered them with rhinos. Really, really nicely countered that split. And Marco does survive this.
Again, you see Ed, some of his tanks that aren't being babysat getting picked on by these paradrops. Very, very annoying.
Wow.
And so Ed got a few miners out of that, but a lot of Mirages coming now. Man, and the Deso Bomb, you know, even at the A-class level, right behind like the super pros like this, oftentimes it's the Deso Bomb, it's like flipping a coin. Those guys, watching those guys do that dance, the Deso, the movement, how the way they played off it, absolute work of art. You love to see it. Deso's now, a lot of Deso's in this group. Marco needs to run, loses a couple.
Yeah, but Ed now on the hyper defensive here, and his economy
bank.
Starting to look, well, actually he's rich, but
13K
he doesn't have
bank.
Any good mining. Wow.
Battle lab for Ed? Love. Ed's not a battle lab builder. Regular Red Alert 2, Ed usually sells the MCV before the third War Factory. Ed needs to get over to Battle Lab Tech.
Ed defends this. They're still in a stalemate, Ivra.
Yep.
I mean, I love Marco's expansion a little bit more than Ed. Ed needs to think about expanding to another ore patch. His economy is currently, he has a lot of money in the bank, but he will start running out. But they're still in a kind of stalemate position. Marco really doesn't have the offensive power to really finish off Ed currently. Ed also, every time he tried to attack, couldn't. And now Marco finally building that power plant. He placed it right in the beginning in the top. Now he's building
now
off of it.
And he's... So Marco now, his economy getting back up. He's got six miners now. Eight miners now. And he's on those gems top left, which will give him a nice little boost. Mirage is hunting top. Ooh, bottom side. Get one miner, two miners at least.
Yeah.
Very nice. Just looking for gaps in the armor here as both these guys take a little bit of a breath, realizing now they are moving into a very serious late game. And Ed 11K, still no battle lab? Is curious to me.
I think a battle lab would be a nice move here for the Soviet player. I think an IC and a Kirov forced out player to get off Mirages for a little while and try to be annoying would definitely be nice. Look at these Mirage on the bridge. Look at these Mirage on the bridge that Marco placed randomly. That the Rhinos pass right under. That is just a GOAT move right there. And now Chrono Legionnaires out. Marco learning from me
what
the best unit in the game is.
The Chrono King himself in here to break down these tactics.
The Chrono Legionnaires are out. Ed's got a couple Deso bombs to try to go to work with here. Ed on 12K. Marco's economy is catching up with him now. Marco now out with Harriers. Man. Yeah, the way that the Deso bombs, it was so interesting the way the Deso bombs, they didn't get stuffed, like they didn't get completely countered, and they didn't completely work. It was just like a weird limbo with each one, like each one got a little bit of value. You don't expect that. Rhino's top side to get completely wrecked.
Absolutely. Marco successfully defending another one of Ed's attacks here, and Marco just looking impregnable at the moment, not showing any chinks in the armor. There is, I think, a Deso Bomb in this flak track here. We'll see what kind of value he's able to get, but then he rushes it in, and he deploys! Oh, but it's split second too late, and he gets his own Rhinos, catching only three Mirages. Marco again coming out way on top. Deso is going to try to zone as Ed splits off. Could get the Aura Purifier, gets the Aura Purifier. Now the Deso's right on top, and now Rocketeer's coming in to clean up the Deso's. That's going to be it. Marco, there's way too many Mirages.
How does Marco... I swear those Deso bombs are just about perfect. And literally, Marco's Mirages tiptoe off the radiation. Ed ends up Deso bombing himself. A split second earlier, if you would have sent me a screenshot, I would have thought it was a good Deso bomb. But yeah, Marco just already moving out of the way just a second too fast. Really shows how quick he is as a player.
Absolutely, absolutely. Ivor, we do have a guest here in the voice chat. If you want to. Okay, anyway. Really? So,
someone's in the chat?
Yes, I like their sound.
Oh my gosh. Okay, all right. Well, anyway. Mirage's bottom side, Desolators to counter. Mirage's top side. So, yeah, so Marco. What?
No, that's not me, Ivor. That's exactly my point.
Oh my gosh. This is so weird. It's so funny. An awesome game like this. Like, what could go wrong? Random person in the chat with a terrible mic. Love it. All right, so the problem is Marco doesn't have a ton of offensive potential right now because of his...
Beautiful Desolator cutoff there. Marco losing a lot of Mirages there. Ed is not giving up. He keeps pounding and pounding and pounding. This is insane. Okay, he's pushing off Ed on the left-hand side, but now the Deso's moving into position here to force these Mirages back. Another Deso bomb gets destroyed, but there's so many Desolators on the field now. Somehow this game is not over yet, Ivor.
Oh my gosh,
they've literally been hammering each other. Oh my god.
The Desolator and the Desolator zone.
Oh my god, that's huge.
Okay, Marco on the backside is eating all of Ed's miners. He just lost a ton of miners on the backside here. The Desolator's still, but Ed does a good job with the Desos, but no attacking army left. These Mirages, I think, just took like five or six miners. He's got some Mirages bottom right as well. It was another nice attack from Ed. Oh, and Ed bottom side getting some miners.
Ed with his own split, and now the Chrono Legionnaires to counter.
The Chrono Legionnaires countering.
Holy, what a game. This is one of the craziest games I've ever seen in my life. This is insane. Now, they're all over the place. Marco's up top now in the top right getting value in the bottom left. Ed coming out to get value against Marco. They are not stopping. They are not resting. Ed eventually will run
Ed's
out of miners.
He
needs to make some miners.
Ed's
God.
Marco's broke.
What?
Marco's
And look at
broke.
This. What? Ed is pushing in here in the bottom. He's winning this fight, Ivor.
He's
targeting the Chrono Legionnaire.
No flak.
But no anti-air. No anti-air.
Still Mirages. Ed's lost so many miners. There's still Mirage on the backside. And now these Rhinos go AFK. Completely AFK.
Ed, wake up. Wake up, Ed.
Marco has
now Marco remembers they exist. Those five Mirages he put there 10 minutes ago. Holy moly, these Rocketeers getting so much value here. Now flak tracks start rushing across the map to try to help and support this Rhino group. We'll see if it's enough. Ed targeting these Mirages, but the flak getting cut off. Oh, man.
I mean, the big thing is Ed, Marco's economy, both these guys' economies. I think Ed has had money in the bank. He had a nice savings account, but I feel like he's about to go. I feel like he's lost so many miners. He's still got five. There's no miner working here. These guys are on dirt. This guy's on dirt. This guy's on dirt.
Dude, Ed needs to expand or sell his MCV, either or.
Yeah.
I don't know what's going on here. You no longer have the money to tech up, so you either need to expand or you got to sell your MCV to get some cash back. That's the only way to do this. Now, on the left-hand side, we see Marco also with a very, very bad economy. These Rocketeers getting value in the top right. Ed out of position to defend here. Now sending one flak track to try to counter. There's an elite Rocketeer in that group, which does damage so quickly. More flak tracks coming out. Ooh, they're trying to zone him out. Marco does escape, and the Mirage numbers start growing again. Marco's army looking formidable again.
Okay, and the big reason we talk about super weapons. Super weapons are the gift that keep on giving. You buy them one time, they keep giving you value. And now, hindsight 2020, Ed wishes he had an Iron Curtain. If you know you're going to be playing a 15-minute game, Iron Curtain, of course, just gives so much value, especially when you start running out of money in the late game. So unfortunate that Ed wasn't able to get over to Battlelab Tech. I like the mindset of trying to do it the old-fashioned way with Dessos and Rhinos. Honestly, I think the way Ed's playing is that there's a couple people in the world that would be holding off right now. Marco happens to be one of them.
Absolutely. The amount of Deso bombs, the amount of pressure, the amount of splits that Ed has put off here. It is insane that either of these players are still alive.
Is we
are
Dessos?
Seeing Dessos? A class
Dessos?
Act big. Here. Oh my god.
Big.
Huge. But still, too many Mirage survive. Ed, get out of the way!
He still tiptoes off, I swear. I mean, that is one of those one snark. It's a half a second. It's a tile different, right? One cell closer.
Absolutely.
And all those Mirages go down. I just can't. He just keeps tiptoeing off. I can't.
That is insane. Marco's reaction, he is so good at reacting to Deso bombs. It is insane. What we're seeing right now, Ed is going to try and push in again. There's a single Desolator there, but it goes down. Ed trying to target down the Mirages, but it's not going to be enough. And more Mirage reinforcements coming in. Ed does get pushed off, but in the bottom, Ed with a split, harassing Marco's miners here, but Rocketeers and more Mirages to counter. They're all over the place. Look at all these refineries from Marco. Marco has literally been expanding all over this map. And that actually is a compliment to the map, Ivory. You can literally build from one point to another all the way across the map.
You can build anywhere. Yeah, it's amazing. And so he's opting for the refinery stretch. Instead of going AFK on the ore factory, he wants to keep pumping Mirages. So he's stretching with those refineries. Marco should get himself a nice economy rolling here very shortly. Both players scraping the bottom of the barrel at the moment. I think Marco's going to come into a late game with a better economy, though. Ed on a couple Mirages. This is exhausting to have.
Dude,
insane. It's exhausting for me, Snark. All I'm doing is sitting here drinking espresso bullshitting with you. I can't imagine to be these guys right now.
This is absolutely nuts. And Ed again pressuring the bottom. Marco doesn't have enough of a response here. The Mirages in the bottom go down. Ed is going to be able to harass Marco's economy again. And more Mirages coming
in. Are there Dessos in here? Ed's got
that could be huge.
Ed's got a Deso bomb assembly line. I'm not sure if there are Dessos in those ones. Doesn't look like
it. I guess there aren't. Or he would have used them. And Marco does manage to push Ed off here. Although a nice harassment from Ed. In the meantime, back in Ed's base, Desolators to counter Marco's Mirages. And Marco can't push in here. He's going to have to go around. They're still at it, Ivor. This game is not over, and it's still unclear. I mean, Marco feels like he's in a better position, but Marco's still unable to push to get any type of critical value.
Yeah, he just hasn't been able to. He's been, and that's one of the things, like Mirage tanks, what are they good at? Killing Rhinos. What are they bad at? Offensively attacking, right? Especially with the Soviet has Desolator. So, Marco doesn't really have much money to switch you over to. Like, if he could mass Rockies, if he could mass Prism tanks, but doesn't really have the money he needs to keep pumping Mirages to keep his head above water, to hold off Ed. And the cost of that is he doesn't really have an offensive presence at the moment. Does radiation go up bridges?
Radiation does go up bridges.
If you're under
absolutely.
A bridge, the radiation goes up.
Yes. Wow, this is just nuts. This is completely nuts. Now, finally, Ed expands and moves his MCV at long last.
Yeah.
It's about time, but there's Mirages there waiting for him. And, Ed losing a fight down bottom. Got to lose a mine or two down here. Loses two miners.
Oh, there's Mirages right there.
Retreat.
Ed didn't see those Mirages. And now
Ed
I can't deploy.
Ed walks right into that. It's over.
The Mirages say nothing here but us trees. And
that is a killing blow. Holy
that's
wow.
Gotta be. And that is so funny. Like, how did Marco win? Marco did this thing called not losing until his opponent literally just like couldn't go any longer. It's called the pure exhaustion strategy. Don't get into a marathon with Marco.
The pure exhaustion strategy, absolutely. Death by a trillion billion cuts here.
Yeah.
This game looked like it was never going to end as each player constantly had a presence in the other person's base. Absolutely insane. These Elite Rocketeers, there we go. The Mirage taking out that Desolator and Ed's base slowly, slowly shrinking here. What a crazy game.
I got to say, I got to give Ed credit here because... it's one thing to just to sell your MCV, bum rush him, hope he makes a mistake and then get close and be like, oh, I got close. I went super aggressive. I got close. That's one thing, right? But to play this kind of late game, to go 20 minutes blow for blow with the GOAT, That is, that's very, very impressive. I mean, and it's a huge compliment to both of these players. I mean, Ed played that so well, and Marco just like he's, I picture Marco like a ninja with one hand behind his back, the other hand just like deflecting sword blows. But wow, that was, both those guys genuinely care about our entertainment, clearly.
That was insane.
Yeah, that was a pretty intense match, man. I know I'd stopped building for a while there, too. I racked up like 18K at some point. I was like, shit.
Yeah, now what did you think about not going Battle Lab Tech? Obviously, at the 20-minute mark, you wish you would have. But early on, you just, did you keep thinking you were going to crack it open? You didn't want to go Battle Lab?
Well, yeah, I just didn't even think about it. I mean, I'm just constantly fighting like three different groups of Mirage tanks, yeah, and I'm trying to avoid paradrops. Like, I'm trying to go around cliffs that have paradrops to not get chip damage.
Yeah, that was so annoying, dude. He was just such a surgeon with those paradrops. They were in all these nooks and crannies and a lot of your reinforcements. So trying to keep the aggression on while trying to babysit your reinforcements to the front lines, and then also on the back end trying to keep up macro. Hey, that is very, very nice, man.
Here, hold this.